Welcome to the world television debut of a growing sport, power tumbling and trampolining. The International Trampoline Federation governs 100,000 athletes worldwide and sponsors over 30 international competitions annually. Strength, athletic skill, and grace in motion combine in each of the four events. So sit back and enjoy your introduction to an up-and-coming sport in the gymnastics field. Direct from the concourse in San Diego, California, Prime Network presents the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games. Hello, everyone. I'm Bill Land. We're glad you could join us today. Going to be fun as the television world comes to the world of gymnastics that you might not have seen before. We're going to take a look at things, sure, the trampoline as well as synchronized trampoline. We'll also have the double mini tramp, and we'll also have a chance to look at power tumbling. We're glad to have with us today Tim Schlosser, who is the Gymnastics Academy of Rockford coach, who's joined us here out of Illinois. Tim, going to be a lot of fun today. We start off telling you exactly what you're going to see, and we start with, I guess, the one people are most familiar with, and that's the trampoline.
Right, the trampoline event, you're going to see athletes jumping 25 to 30 feet into the air and then performing 10 optional skills, multiple flipping double somersaults, and hopefully staying on the trampoline.
Next up, we'll also have a chance to look at synchronized trampolining, and that's something that's a little bit new.
Right, synchronized trampolining is basically individual trampoline done side by side. Now, the partners must concentrate on keeping in sync with their partner throughout the 10 bounce routine.
Power tumbling, someone mentions that to you, and you kind of wonder just exactly what is that. I think it might be the most exciting event we've got here.
Yeah, the power tumbling competition you'll see today is probably one of the best in the world. They start with a run down a runway, and then they do 10 skills down the mat and finish with a big skill right at the end.
Well, if you combine the tumbling along with the trampoline, you come up with something called the double mini tramp.
Right, the double mini trampoline is a combination of both the tumbling and the trampoline events. It starts with an approach run, and then they perform skills on the double mini and a dismount skill off onto a hard landing mat.
Going to be a lot of fun today. We've got seven countries represented. Stay with us here in San Diego. We'll be back with more in just a minute.
Beauty, skill, and power. The American Trampoline and Tumbling Association combines it all in a sport that is growing in popularity worldwide. With over 6,500 members in 35 states, ATTA is an affiliated sports organization of the United States Olympic Committee and the national governing body for power tumbling and trampoline. ATTA emphasizes safety and education through coaching certification and a mobility system from recreational and beginner programs through the elite level. Gymnastics, dancers, cheerleaders, divers, and more are finding ATTA the organization of the future for their programs. For more information, contact the ATTA by calling 806-637-8670 or write to 1610 East Cardwell, Brownfield, Texas, 79316.
Welcome back to the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego, California at the concourse. Bill Land with you along with Tim Schlosser on Home Sports Entertainment and Prime Network. We're glad to have the Prime Network families with us. We start off with the first of four events. We'll be going alternate back and forth between the women's trampoline finals and then the men's double mini finals. And the first competitor is Angela O'Brien here in the finals of the trampoline. She's from New Zealand and 19 years old.
Angela's actually a member of their world championship team that competed at the last Worlds in 92 in New Zealand.
Tim, explain the warm-up period here so our viewers understand what's going on when the routine actually starts.
Okay, she's just preparing to begin the routine now. They are allowed as many jumps as they need, and she's into the routine. Now, you want to watch to see if she keeps her height and stays as close to the center cross as possible. That was a pretty good exercise. A little bit of traveling around and a little loss of height, some minor form problems. We'll have to wait and see how the judges score it.
Angela O'Brien from New Zealand, who does a little gymnastics coaching herself at age 19, second year of college. Here's a look at her.
Okay, there she's establishing her height, and there's a double pike back somersault, and then a branny, which is just a front somersault with a half twist, a tuck double backward somersault, a half out tuck, a back somersault piked, a Rudy, and she's showing good form, a little bit of pike down, but her kickouts are good, a double twist, a back straight, Pretty good routine.
Angelo O'Brien. And in the finals, our competitors will go in an order from last to first, if you will, from how they finished in the preliminaries as we move now to the double mini finals on the double mini tramp. And this is Steve Anderson of the USA.
And Steve's really, really excited about competing here. He was the alternate to the world championship, so he's really fortunate to be in the finals here at this event. Over and a double layout. Two somersaults with the body completely straight. Now you saw he took a couple of steps. The judges have to take deductions if they do not stick their landing.
A 66-foot run-up area that the gymnasts are able to take advantage of. Here's a look at it and explain what you're talking about where they might take points off.
Okay, well right there he's a little bit poor body shape and his arms were out. And right there a little bit too much arch. But pretty good. Pretty good overall. A couple of steps on the landing, they got to take at least 2/10.
Steve Anderson from the United States. And now we go back to the women's finals in the trampoline. And from the Japanese team, there are 7 different countries represented here today. This is Noguchi Tomoe, and they have an outstanding group of trampolinists.
Yeah, Tomoe is not actually a member of the Japanese senior team. She's planning on throwing a 7-7 BD. Good job of keeping it right on the center. Well, there's an example of a routine that was done very well in the center of the trampoline, but some of the body shapes and the positioning in the air are not really what international trampoline judges are looking for. You want to be straight, arms kept in at all times.
Tomoe had a 52.4 in the preliminaries earlier today.
This is the end of a routine here. It's a full twisting back somersault. And there's a Rudy, the 1.5 twisting forward somersault, a back pike. And this is called a 1 3/4 front to land on the back. And that trick's called a Rudy ball out from a salto off the back.
And now to the double mini finals again as Richard Hartman, another American, ready to run.
Richard's been on the American team for the last 5 years. He's got a lot of competitive experience. Flip this over and a half in, half out, but then again, he was close to the area, the penalty zone, landing out of the yellow area where you need to be. You can see the judges discussing.
And it's interesting, first opportunity I've had a chance to see this competition, the intensity is much more than we had in the preliminaries earlier today.
Right, well this is what we call new life finals, and pretty much everybody starts from scratch. The preliminary scores don't carry over, and it looked like he was just on the line. And so it's anybody's ballgame, anybody could win it.
Looking at Richard Hartman, as we move back to the women's trampoline, and Bianca Shaw from New Zealand.
See Bianca preparing there. Want to get as much height as possible and still maintain a lot of control.
Bianca Shaw of New Zealand with the competition. See, she seems to be pleased.
Bianca.
Okay, if you can watch Bianca right there on that double twister, she loses her feet, her legs cross. Then again there on the other twister, the Rudy Salto, she twists her feet. And those are all deductions the judges will take.
We move from Bianca Shaw, New Zealand, to Israel Martins from Canada.
Okay, there is Israel performing a half-out tuck to a double pikeback somersault. And he had some form problems on that one.
Martins at a 12.8 in the preliminaries today. Here's another look.
Okay, right there. There's double front with a half twist, but you can see didn't extend. And there's the double pike somersault and loose legs on the landing. Probably won't get a great score for that one.
We'll have the scoring for you. We're going to take a brief timeout. We'll be back with more in San Diego. You're watching the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games here on Prime Network. More coming up in just a minute. Welcome back to the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games here on Prime Network. I'm Bill Land along with Tim Schlosser, and glad to have you with us here in San Diego as we are in the middle of the women's trampoline finals as well as going back and forth to the men's double mini trampoline finals. And next up, Coralie Puchmeyer from Canada.
Coralie is planning on throwing a 7-2 degree of difficulty, which is a pretty good level of difficulty, not quite as high as some of the other competitors you'll see later on. She's getting her height. There she goes. Good routine. She had nice style, nice height. Kept the routine pretty much in the center of the trampoline. Should score well.
How much can just the personality help a performer here? Because you see so many of the gals and the guys that if they maintain that smile and that bubble about them, it seems like it certainly can't hurt.
Yeah, well, there's actually no points given or taken away for being a great personality. But I think you're right. I think that, you know, they show enthusiasm and excitement, and the judges can't help but appreciate them more.
Coralie Puchmeyer from Canada, the women's trampoline. Here in the Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego. And now to Jai Wallace from Australia in the double mini finals.
Jai's got a good strong run going. Strong Rudy out tuck, half in Rudy out tuck. That is a terrific routine.
And you can hear by the applause here that the fans that have come out, many of the competitors, of course, that did not make the finals are staying. And when they react, you know when it's been a good score.
Right. This was just really great. He'd had great form and height on both of the skills, that mounter skill, and then this dismount right here was terrific. Look at the feet squeezed, and he just planted it. One small step. He's got to be happy with that one.
Jai Wallace from Australia. Speaking of some of the fans around here, as we get ready for Sally Ann Propach to come up, we've also had, besides the Indo-Pacific Games competition here, we've had the national championships been going on preceding this here in San Diego. So a lot of the youngsters that have been a part of the competition, and they too, of course, have stayed to watch this great competition.
Well, as we watch Sally Ann get ready, Australia actually finished sixth as a team at the World Championships, and she was a part of that team. Jumping, she's got beautiful toe point and really good leg form. Getting into a little bit of trouble, but there's a pretty good finish. She really started out well, and then she got into a little bit of trouble right in the middle section, broke form a little bit.
Sally Ann Propach from Australia.
You can see there's where the trouble started. She starts bending her legs a little bit. She gets it back together pretty well. But then on this finish, that's a 1 3/4 front pike. She overspins a little bit and then loses that Rudy ball out a little bit, traveling feet apart.
Waits her score along with her coach. And next up to the double mini finals, and from New Zealand, it's Tony Costley, a 20-year-old who also does a little rugby and swimming as a builder's assistant.
Spotted double full, and that's very unfortunate because that pass would probably be scored out of zero if he hit the side pad. There you can see. Next, there's the spotter double pull, and he comes down and hits the end pad, so of course that will receive no score, just a zero mark.
Unfortunate for Tony Costley, you can see the disappointment as he visits. Yeah, Costley certainly got, was costly with that move, wasn't he? As we go back to the women's finals here on the trampoline, and Tokuma Hiroi.
Hiroi's another one of their up-and-coming trampolinists. She's not on their senior team that competed at the World Championship, so I'm interested to see what she'll do. It's Rudy out pike, Granny out pike, back pike, half out tuck, double pike, a Rudy, a back straight, and a double tuck, one and three pike, and a Randy ball out, two and a half twists off the back. Pretty good routine.
Man, tell the happiness there.
And with athletes like Tokuma, Japan is really building their program up to be competitors on the world scene.
When you bring competitors in from different countries like this, you see something every once in a while, you just go, hey, where'd you come up with that?
Yeah, well...
Or is it pretty basic no matter where you go?
No, once in a while you'll get blown away. I think that people like the Soviet athletes from the former Soviet Union are setting trends and developing things, and sometimes the Canadians too.
Here's Gary Hedrick from the USA.
Wow, good for Gary. Gary's been around forever. He's one of the grand old men of the United States trampoline team. Here he comes down the mat. That's a piked fliffus, or a piked double front with a half twist, and a double somersault in the pike position. Good kick out. Pretty good landing. One little step.
We're going to take a brief time out as you look at Gary Hedrick. Glad to have you with us here on Prime Network today. You're watching the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games. Back with more at the concourse in San Diego after these messages. Welcome back to the Indo-Pacific Games 1993 as we take a look at Christy Hayes here in the finals of the women's trampoline. She is the seventh out of 10 competitors.
That's a beautiful start for Christy. Moving really well. There's a little trouble, but she saved a nice routine.
Almost home turf for Christy. She has her home in Villa Park, California. Goes to Chapman University.
Here's Christy forming her half-out tuck. And there was the problem. She leaned back on that double pike, traveled the whole tramp. She did a good job not to come off and just finish the routine.
Christy, a 55.8 in the preliminaries. Waiting for the scoring as we move back to the mini tramp, the double mini tramp, and Paul Cameron from Canada.
Paul's a terrific athlete for the Canadians. He's got a real good shot at winning this. Half-out pike, but that's a big mistake.
What happened?
Well, he obviously planned to do something much harder as his dismount skill, but he was either felt that he was a little off axis. Maybe we can get a better angle here. On this half-out pike, you can see him just listing over to the side of the double mini tramp, and when you're that close to the end pad, there's just no way that you can pull out a big skill out of there. And actually, I think the judges might have even terminated him on that routine.
So we move back to the women's finals in trampoline, and Jackie Cully from Australia. Australia, New Zealand, of course the USA with the biggest contingent here, Canada, Japan, Argentina, South Africa.
Well, if Cully throws what she's supposed to throw, this will be the highest difficulty in the women's final. She's planned on doing a 10.3, which is very, very strong. to get up high enough. Jean started out very, very strong, but she got into some side-to-side movement at the end, and of course, when that happens, you just want to stay on the trampoline, so you take the DD out and you just work it as best you can. This is a double pike, and there she tucks the second somersault, and she's in trouble here. She's over at that side, and she did a good job to pull it back to the center there, but that was it.
Jackie Cully from Australia, not getting to do exactly what she had hoped, but still all right. And we go back to the double mini, and Carl Hager, 30-year-old Carl Hager from the United States, and guy who has already picked up the most important medal, and that's from Desert Storm Operations, where he was a leader.
Carl's just a terrific man. He's been in the sport a long time, and he's just an all-around good guy, and I really hope he does well here. And that was wonderful. No movement on that landing whatsoever.
Well, Hager had the third best score in the preliminaries. Certainly got to be happy here.
Yeah, this is a really terrific mini tramp routine. This is a half-out pike. It's real square. There's a full in, full out, puck position, and of course a great landing. It's going to put the pressure on the guys that were ahead of him from the preliminaries.
Hager out of Manhattan, Kansas, puts the heat on him. Michael Johnston and Chris Mitrick to follow. And we go back to the women's trampoline, and Jennifer Sands from Apple Valley, Minnesota, from USA Team, just 13.
And Jennifer is just an outstanding young trampoliner. She's really, really got a bright future in this sport, and I have been impressed with her all during training. As a matter of fact, she's our new national champion.
Jennifer with a 57.3 in the preliminaries earlier today.
Really good job. Routine for Jennifer Sands. She could have had a major problem there at the end, but she hung tough and brought the exit bounce. That's the last skill after they're done with their saltos back to the center and didn't touch that end pin. Showing good position there. This is a double pike, little knee bend, but she kicks out well. That's 1.5 twists. A double tuck back somersault. Good extension again. Good routine for Jennifer Sands. She's young and she's got a bright future.
Still waiting for the scoring as Michael Johnston sets up from Australia in the double mini tramp finals.
And Michael's ranked number 2 in Australia actually in double mini, so he has to be considered one of the favorites here. There he goes, got a good run. Clean routine, but you can't land off the yellow zone.
So you get too much height.
I don't think there's such a thing as too much height, but what happened was I think he dropped his shoulder and got a little off in direction there. So it's beautiful height, but as you can see, he was leaning into the dismount skill and caused a big problem.
Why didn't they move that yellow over a little bit? I was up long enough. Sorry, Michael Johnston. And now the final competitor in the women's trampoline, and then we'll come back to the final in the men's double mini. This is Franny Jewett out of Toronto, Canada, 18-year-old Canadian.
A think Franny really has to be considered the favorite here. She has a good degree of difficulty, and she has a wonderful form. She's coached by Dave Ross. She's competed on 3 Canadian world teams. So she's been around a long time, and she's not very old yet.
Eighth year of competition in the elite level.
That was a terrific trampoline routine. That's going to be tough for anybody at the top.
She has qualified, I guess, to do some judging and some coaching. How much does that help you when you come back to perform? Or does it?
Well, I think it really does. I think that it's good that the athletes know the rules that well, and you know, they see all aspects of the sport. You can see here the trick she's doing. That's, there is a half in, half out. And then there is a branny out tuck. Good routine for Franny Jewett. She's got to be happy with that.
As we go back to the double mini finals, we had one pass earlier that you did not get the opportunity to see. We'd like to show it to you because it is the run that Chris Mietrich had in the earlier run.
Okay, this is Chris. That's a branny, or that's a full in branny out straight and a full in double full out off, which we call a Miller. And that was a new difficulty record, or actually tied the world record with a 3.1 degree of difficulty.
Here he is in his final pass and the final competitor in the men's double mini, Chris Mietrich of Canada.
His job right now is just not to make a major mistake. He will probably have this competition sewn up. Mistake. Too bad, because you come back from doing something so spectacular, and then one little slip and it's all over.
Mm-mm. See how quickly it fell apart.
Okay, that's the Brannian full out, and he's way too far over, and he did a really good job of just saving his life on that one. Can see he lands right on the end of the mini, and he slings that full. It was supposed to be a full in full out, and he slung it way back, and he did a really good job just to save himself injury. He's rubbing his shoulder. I hope he didn't get hurt.
Let's hope he's all right. We're gonna take a break. We'll be back with the men's synchro tramp as well as the women's power tumbling coming up next from the 1993 Indo Pacific Games here in San Diego on Prime Network. Welcome back to the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego here on Prime Network. I'm Bill Land along with Tim Schlosser, and glad to have you with us today. Let's take a look at the final results from the women's trampoline as Franny Jewett from Canada, first place at 35.6, followed by Jennifer Sands from the USA at 33.0, Japan's Hiroi at 32.1, and then Sallyann Proposh at 31.9. In fifth place, Cora Lee Puchmeyer at 31.9, actually a tie for fourth there. Your thoughts?
Well, I think it pretty much held true to form. I think Franny Jewett was definitely the class of the competition, but Jennifer Sands, she's one to really watch in the future from the United States.
And then we'll take a look at the others, 6 through 10, Cully, Hayes, O'Brien, Bianca Shaw, and Tomo completing the field. Now on the men's side, the double mini tramp finals. Here's a look at the scoring as Jai Wallace, the champion from Australia, 11.2, a full point better than Michael Johnston, fellow Australian, at 10.2, then Gary Hedrick of the U.S. and even 10, Israel Martins at 8.5, Richard Hartman at 8.5, and the surprise was that Mietrich, who had done so well in the first pass, struggled there on the last one.
Yeah, I think for both Chris Mietrich and Carl Hager, it was kind of disappointing. They received very low scores on one pass and kept him out of it. But Jai Wallace, somebody to look for in the future. And Gary Hedrick is nice to see in third place. Been around a long time and grand old man in medal position there.
And 6 through 10, it was Steve Anderson of the USA, Mietrich from Canada, as we mentioned, Carl Hager, Tony Costley, and Paul Cameron in the men's double mini tramp finals. Now we're ready to get underway with more competition here. We've got the men's synchronized trampoline and the women's tumbling finals, the power tumbling here in San Diego. And going to be a lot of fun here to get our first look at the men's synchronized trampoline and explain again the scoring process and the whole object here, Tim.
Okay, well, with synchronized trampoline, they're going to be doing two actual individual trampoline routines side by side, and the judges will score them on both performance and difficulty. But then the added element is that there will be a synchronized score or a lack of synchronized score that will also figure into the scoring.
And up first, representing Canada, J.P. Aquan and Paul Cameron. J.P. told us, make sure you just use J.P. Be technical, Jean-Paul, but we'll go by J.P. We just thought we ought to report that first off, though, right?
Okay, gentlemen, begin.
Is the scoring done same way? Obviously, with two, you're looking at a little bit different deal here.
Right. Half the panel judge one tramp, half the panel judge the other, and then there's judges spread out on the floor that will judge the synchronization. You can see they're already together right off the bat.
One.
Now they're giving their count. That's to notify that they are ready, and then they begin, and they are right together. You can see as they hit the bat at the same time and then in the air at the same time. So far, so good. And that was a terrific routine.
Who gives the signal there, Tim, to start the routine?
Well, one of the partners usually does. They practice counting in the gym, and some use a clap, some use a count, but they have practiced so much that they have it just down to a science. Those are Rudy outs done simultaneously, half and half out pikes, and you can see they're perfectly together. They even twist with their arms down in the same way.
Unbelievable. Tell you what, if you're sitting at home, do not adjust your television set. Think that, wait a minute, what's happened to my screen here? Synchronized trampoline as Paul Cameron and his Canadian teammate J.P. Aquan, and now we go to the women's power tumbling finals, and this is somebody you can tell us all about, 17-year-old Emily Giglio from Rockford, Illinois. You're her coach.
Yeah, actually, Emily's been looking really good in this competition, and I hope she hits this routine. It's a tough one for her. She looks good. She's moving down the mat well. Big trick on the end. Double pike back. Stabs it.
Wonderful. And she is ecstatic.
We could never tell. First look also at the power tumbling and the track specifications, 86 feet long, 5 feet wide. It's incredible to me they can even stay on the thing.
Yeah, and it's so tough because they're moving so fast and doing so many tricks. Here she is, she's doing good full twisting combinations, and then a back handspring to a high double pike, and she just dropped it in one little step on the landing.
Pretty happy.
Pretty good.
17-year-old Emily Giglio.
Next up for the synchronized trampoline competition.
And we go back to the synchronized Australia, trampoline.
Jai Wallace and
just five
Johnston.
Teams competing here, and it's Michael Johnston and Jai Wallace. The Australians up on the tramp now.
And these two looked really good in the practice session, so they're both very talented individually, but now let's see how they do together.
Did not score as well in the preliminaries. Does that mean much?
Well, actually no, because everything starts from a zero again, so basically they have a clean slate, and if they hit, they could win.
Okay.
Start with a 1 3/4 salto to a granny ball out. They look really good right now. They're right on. Bounce in the middle of the routine. It was a good routine. They had a lower degree of difficulty than Cameron and Aquan because they had single saltos in the middle of the trampoline routine, and really at the best in the world you're going to see double saltos all the way through. There's the half out tuck. They are together. The half and half out tuck. Rudy out tuck. And if you notice, they twist in opposite directions. So that in itself kind of can look differently as far as to the judges and to the audience.
Michael Johnson and Jai Wallace from Australia. And we move again now to the power tumbling finals. And Shannon Mogolis, another American, up next.
And Shannon has a different type of body line for a tumbler. She's very tall, she's got long legs, and she's a wonderful twister. There's a branny, full twist. But a little weak on the ending there. I think she had planned to do a full to immediate double full punch front, and she doesn't look too happy. And she got in a little trouble and just did a simple back tuck punch front on the end.
One more look at it. Shannon Mogolis from the United States.
Shannon loses her feet a little bit in the air, and there's some trouble. She blocked that full real high instead of leaning back on it. Couldn't do the double twist and just had to do a back tuck punch front.
And now to the synchronized trampoline again, Alistair Booth and Israel Martins.
Leaf has a plan to do a 9.0 degree of difficulty. Neither one has a lot of international experience, so.
What?
Getting ready.
From Canada, Booth and Martins.
The outpikes to double tuck. You can see they're a little off. One's hitting before the other, and there he goes. Now, when he came off the trampoline, that'll stop the actual judging process of the routine.
But the other continues.
Yeah, the other continued to finish the routine. But you can see they're handling it pretty well. There's not much you can do. I mean, most of the time you're just glad you didn't come all the way off and you landed on that pad there.
71.8 in the preliminaries. They finished in third. And there's the fall.
Yeah, you can see the spotters flying around the trampoline to make sure he doesn't come all the way off. But it seemed like he had a good attitude about the whole thing.
What is it like? I have a question about that, if it's anything like doubles tennis when we get back to it or not. we'll get on that in just a second. From Argentina, Sabrina Vence.
I've been watching the Argentina girls in warm-up, and they seem to be just a little bit behind. And there you can see some big problems. A little bit behind the rest of the world as far as their skill level. And the reason for this is that they're relatively new to the International Federation. So it'll take some time to get to the same standard as, say, the United States of America.
They did not bring a big contingent at all. Just three competitors came from Argentina.
And you can see there the technical aspect of it, the skill level's not too high. There's a full twist. She pucks her legs in, brings them into a tuck position, and just didn't have the front quite the height, and she's quite upset.
From one side of emotion to the other here at the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego. You're watching Prime Network. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser will be right back with you in just a moment. Glad to have you with us on Home Sports Entertainment, one of the many affiliates of Prime Network, for the presentation of the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego, California. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you as we continue the competition in the synchronized trampoline and the women's power tumbling finals. Next up from Japan, Suga Sasaki Mitsuo and Teruai Takayuki.
And I'm really interested to see what the Japanese perform. They did a couple of different routines in training. And they've written down on their competition cards a 6-8. That's not a very high degree of difficulty. Half-out pikes. There's double somersaults. Half-out tucks. But you can see all these single saltos in the middle of the exercise are just not highly rated difficulty-wise, and that's going to hurt them as far as the difficulty score goes. And there's another mistake. Coming to the end of the routine, it looked good, and then he just leaned a little forward and went to the end pad.
So Mitsuo and Takayuki also struggle.
As far as the synchronization of the routine, when it was pretty good. They seemed to work well together as a team.
This the same as the regular trampoline with 10 skills?
Right, 10 skill routine. There's the difference. You can see he was forward and went to the end pad. Japanese have been great here. They've been having a really good time this whole week.
And now another Argentinian as we go back to the power tumbling. And this is Maria Perez, 17 years old.
Starts with the front pike, around a full twist, whip back, full twist, back tuck, punch front, and a fall to the seat. If you notice throughout the routine seemed to be going upwards through the middle, and in the middle of the exercise, and in tumbling, you want to be long and fast and maybe take the whole mat and finish at the end. There's the front pike, that's nice. Round off, full twist, starts pretty well. There she's leaning back well, whip, whip, and then right there she blocks that full up, has to bend her legs, and then everything just doesn't continue to move as well. And then kicked out a little early, and of course the fall.
You gotta have it all going right when you come back to changing directions.
Exactly, exactly.
Not much margin for error there. Maria Perez, waiting for her score as we move back to the final competitors here in the synchronized trampoline, Max Dempsey and David Kennedy.
Max and David just became our new national synchronized trampoline champions, and they had a good preliminary event. They were the leaders. Surprised a lot of people. And they look right on. And just right at the end, they got a little bit off. But Dave Kennedy actually did a good job of bringing that routine back. He went near the end pad and stayed tough and finished the routine well.
So the Americans, David Kennedy and Max Dempsey, do you change things when you're the last pair to go up and two have come off the tramp and you know that you can go ahead and maybe do something a little bit less difficulty and still score well enough to beat them?
Yeah, it really depends on the athletes. I think if the athletes are really well prepared, they probably won't change anything. But sometimes, you know, if you're in that last position and you see everybody miss in front of you, you might go with a little easier thing to make sure you can stay on your feet.
All right, we'll have the scoring in a few minutes for you on the men's synchronized trampoline finals. But let's go back now and continue with the women's tumbling finals and the power tumbling. And this is 16-year-old Nikki Ahrens from Australia.
And Ahrens starts with a granny, then she's doing whip backs, a full twist, a whip back, a back handspring, full twist, punch granny. That's good routine, nice clean form, moved down the mat well.
Nikki Ahrens of Australia, impressive.
Can see it in slow-mo here. The Branny, she loses her feet a little bit, but then she works herself into the center of the mat. Gets the routine going pretty well. Can see her feet apart and things like that. Those are all deductions that the judges look for.
Nikki Ahrens. Rehashing it with her coach. Next up from Canada will be Jill Boyd.
Jill was actually fifth at the World Championships, so she has to be considered among the favorites besides the very powerful American team. There she goes. Pretty good run. Whip back, full twist, whip back. Uh-oh. It looks like she twisted her ankle or something. I didn't see it happen, but maybe on the slow-mo we can pick up what happened.
Looked like things were going pretty good.
Yeah.
Jill Boyd has to stop, and she's in pain.
Okay, here we go. Run's good. There's a round-off, whip back, full twist. And right there, you saw her foot roll as it hit the mat. And after that happens, when you roll an ankle like that, there's just nothing to do but stop and hopefully hope you didn't break it.
Jill Boyd is helped off. Let's hope she's not hurt seriously. We'll have more coming up when we return with the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games from San Diego, California. Stay with us. We'll continue with women's power tumbling in a moment. We're in San Diego for the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games on Prime Network and Home Sports Entertainment. And next up in the women's power tumbling finals, This is Lisa Cullen from Australia, 16-year-old who, on her notes on biography, said, "I devote all my time to tumbling." Let's see if it's paid off.
Moving well so far. Pretty good pass. Not a lot of difficulty. Really didn't have much content, but she had good form and good speed and stretch. There's a round off, whip back, back handspring, full twist, whip back pike salto, I think, and a front pike. Now that back pike salto really didn't hit a good pike position, so there'll have to be a deduction for that.
Lisa Cullen from Australia and her coach. She's doing a little assistant coaching herself. And now you're looking at Canada's Karen Stevens.
She's a tiny little girl, but boy, is she powerful.
Getting sight right now.
Stevens just missed the finals at the World Championship. She finished 11th. So full twist, full twist, whip back, full twist, double full twist. Good routine, very strong. I have to see how the judges score that.
Just how much spring is there in these elevated spring runways? This is something we might have a chance to talk about.
Yeah, well, actually, that spring floor is made out of fiberglass rods that are underneath that floor. And it really, when you hit the floor right, it can really get you moving down the mat. Can see her there. Double twist, loses the feet just a little bit, but a pretty good landing.
Done.
And now Michelle Mara from Belvidere, Illinois, for the USA, 18-year-old.
Michelle Mara is a two-time world bronze medalist, and she's really just an unbelievable athlete. She's been around a long time, and she's really upgraded the level of difficulty in our sport in this country. She looks good. She's moving really well. That was a terrific exercise. A beautiful full twisting double pike back somersault at the end. In gymnastics, you see a lot of girls perform a full twisting double back salto in the pike position, but not many put that much in front of it. Watch this. Branny right there, whip back, full twist, little form deductions, but she's moving through it so well. She is so strong. And look at great height, super lift, and she just nails it.
That routine may exemplify power tumbling more than anything we've seen here so far today. I mean, that was fantastic.
Right.
What a job by Michelle Mara. And now another American, Kendra Stuckey.
And Kendra and Michelle actually tied for the national title this year. So there's been quite a rivalry going on between these two girls. And Kendra can twist like a top.
She's got a score she's going to have to match.
Right. She's really preparing. There she goes. Branny, double twist in the middle of the routine. Full twist, whip over, whip over. Triple twisting back somersault with perfect leg form. Wow, she is so happy. What a competition for these women.
And don't the rules state something about waiting for 2 or 3 seconds for the judges? Well, she wasn't waiting this time, though, was she?
No.
She knew what she had.
Let's see what she does here. Branny, immediate double twist, and then she bounds right out of it with whip back, full twist, whip back, and right here, triple twisting back somersault, and that is finished and beautiful. And she's really happy. Here's a national
incredible
team coach, Terry White, with her.
We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll have the scoring for you in the women's power tumbling as well as the wrap-up of the men's synchronized trampoline. So stay with us here on Prime Network in the Indo-Pacific Games 1993 from San Diego, California. Welcome back to the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you. Let's take a look at some scoring and the results that we've got to update you with on the men's synchronized trampoline. And Paul Cameron and J.P. Aucoin combined to win the synchronized trampoline from Canada with a score of 45.20. They were followed by Australians Michael Johnston and Jai Wallace. Kennedy and Dempsey of the USA finished third at 41.40. Mitsuo and Takayuki at 34.10 from Japan. And then Booth and Martins finish in fifth position from Canada at 11.7. Next, we'll take a look at the final results from the women's power tumbling. And no surprise, Kendra Stuckey of the USA, number one. Michelle Mara of the USA, number two. And it's a sweep. And certainly, Tim is excited about number three as Emily Giglio, his student, finishes third, followed by Karen Stevens and Shannon Mogolis.
It was really great seeing that happen. The Americans 1-2-3, Kendra and Michelle, you know, two of the best in the world, and Emily really showing that the USA is the country to be reckoned with in women's power tumbling.
And we have a revised score on the women's trampoline that was held earlier. Nothing changing as far as the top. Franny Jewett still wins, but there was a protest and appeal, and Cora Lee Puchmeyer now switches positions and goes from fourth to third and actually wins a medal.
Right, and probably what happened there is that the difficulty score was incorrect. Puchmeyer protested the judging panel, got the correct score put in, and unfortunately knocked somebody out of a medal.
So there's a look at the official results from the women's trampoline. And now, in our next segment, we'll have a chance to take a look at the women's double mini tramp finals as well as the men's trampoline finals here at the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games.
Now, this is Melissa Larson, and she's from Minnesota, and she is a three-time U.S. team member. That's a spotter double twist to a Barani out tuck. Just a little bit crooked on that double twist and didn't get a lot of height on her half-out dismount.
A lot of experience for Melissa, who was a USA World team member in 88, 90, and 92.
You can watch her right here. There's the double twisting back salto. She's just not quite as high as she should be on the other, on the dismount skill, but she does a good job to pull it around.
Melissa Larson, 19, from Bloomington, Minnesota. Next, Paul Cameron, we've seen earlier in the competition, now in the men's tramp final, from Canada, North York, Ontario, 17 years old.
And Paul really is...
22, I beg your pardon.
Paul really has to be considered one of the favorites. He finished seventh at the 1992 World Championships in Auckland, New Zealand. So he is definitely one of the favorites.
Many years of elite competition for Paul Cameron from Canada.
Now a little bit there, but he's brought it back to the center. It's very, very strong. Beautiful routine from Paul Cameron. As you can see, there were many double somersaults, all double somersaults in that routine, a lot of multiple twisting double somersaults, and a lot of them done in the straight body position. Okay, right here, that's a half in, half out pike. Then he does a flip his tuck or a half out tuck. A half and half out tuck, and then you notice as he kicks out of the trick, his arms are in by his sides. It's a Brani in, full out straight, arms down by the sides, and a full in, full out straight, and arms completely by the side, straight body position. Really, really a good job.
Ever wonder what it feels like to be like Michael Jordan? Ask Paul Cameron. Nice routine by Paul from Canada. And back to the women's double mini finals, and this is Nikki Vanderwalt from South Africa.
Nikki doesn't have much experience competing in the FIT because South Africa was not allowed to compete from 82 to 92, and she just did a great job.
FIT, meaning the International Trampoline Federation.
That's a Rudy overmount and a double twisting dismount. Pretty good landing, one big step.
Nikki Vanderwall. Next on the tramp, Michael Johnston, warming up, 24 years old.
Michael's planning on throwing a 12.3 degree of difficulty. That would be one of the highest we'll see today. Got some momentum on him. There's a Triffus tuck. Half and Rudy out pike. Rudy out pike. Half and Rudy out tuck. Rudy out tuck. Half and half out tuck. Branny and full out piked. Half and half out piked. And too bad, because the routine was really moving well. But it happens that fast in trampolining. You just get a little off on one skill and the next one can come completely off the bed.
24-year-old Michael Johnston from Australia.
As you can see right here, he's in real good shape. And then right there, he just hit the salto forward and nothing you can do except be disgusted.
Double mini.
Yeah, and his expression pretty well shows that. Particularly frustrating, as you mentioned, when things are going so well. And next up will be Karen Stevens. We saw her earlier. She is in the double mini.
As a granny over to a double tuck tuck somersault. It's a relatively easy routine for this level of competition. Usually you want to see two double somersaults or single somersaults with very large amount of twisting.
First year she's competed in the elite level of the double mini.
Not bad form, but not quite up there with the rest of the girls in the competition.
15-year-old Karen Stevens from Alberta, Canada. And on the men's trampoline finals, the third competitor out of 10, Justin Dougal from New Zealand.
Well, Justin is relatively new to senior men's competition. He is a junior, and he's only going to be throwing an 8.5 degree of difficulty.
So close, he was able to balance himself there and stay on. Justin Dougal from New Zealand, just 13 years old.
You can see here he's performing a double twisting back somersault and a 1 3/4 front pike and then a Rudy off his back, which we call a ball out. Wasn't a lot of difficulty in that exercise and really can't compete with some of the other guys in the field.
More coming up from the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games. We'll continue with the women's double mini trampoline finals as well as the men's trampoline finals. Stay with us from beautiful San Diego here on Prime Network. Back in San Diego, Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you, and glad to have you aboard here on the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games on Prime Network as we continue in our competition. And now on the women's side, the double mini tramp finals. This is Bianca Shaw from New Zealand, 16 years old.
And New Zealand has an outstanding tradition of really producing great female double mini trampolinists. They always have a very respectable team. There's a spotted full to a half out tuck. Didn't look like there was a penalty on that, but she didn't have a lot of extension or a lot of height on that Fliffus tuck at the end.
Saw the smile. She was the winner 92 of the New Zealand Trampoline Sportsmanship Award. So even if things don't go well, she's got the right spirit. Bianca Shaw.
1 foot.
You didn't stay well, did you?
And now, from Japan, Narita Shinobu.
And I believe Narita's relatively new as well to the Japanese team. They planned on throwing a 6.5 degree difficulty, which again is not at the highest level.
You mentioned during the break, though, that plans can change real quickly.
Right. A lot of times we get the difficulty that the athlete is planning to throw, but they might get in trouble in the middle of the exercise and have to perform some easier skills in order to get themselves back in the center of the bed or back at a height where they're capable of doing it. That's a very clean routine, but like I said, without those high flying, multiple twisting multiples, you just can't score that well.
And you're basically getting 10 touches, 10 skills, and obviously if you do the lesser skill because something hasn't gone right, you're not going to get the higher score.
Exactly. You can see he finished with a back straight to a 1-3 pike and a Barani ball out straight. It was well done, but again, relatively simple in comparison to some of the other athletes.
And now to Karen Vandermeer from Kent City, Michigan. 15-year-old who is quite a swimmer as well.
Karen's one of those just incredibly talented young girls. She's a good tumbler. She's good on the trampoline. She's excellent on the double mini. And that was a great routine. She's got to be happy with that.
Had it all together that time, didn't she?
From the United States, Max Dempsey.
Sometimes you don't need to say anything, do you?
Exactly. Right there, she does a Rudy over and a double pike back somersault. Good toe point. Kicks it out right into the pot of gold.
Good.
6-5.
Oh, my God.
Good, Karen. Back on the men's trampoline, this is Max Dempsey out of Alabama, 20-year-old American.
Max is on the U.S. team to New Zealand. Been around for a long time. And he's doing pretty well, but you see he's dropping in height. Really dropping in height. Trying to save what he can. Oh! He was just way too low to throw that back and pull out straight, so.
But there's maybe the point you're trying to make, that when, if you don't make those adjustments and make it simpler, you're really taking the risk that you're going to blow the whole thing.
Exactly. He did the right thing by making the skill simpler, but then he just cranked that back and pull out straight, and the bed caught him, and his head got caught beneath the springs there, I think. But Max will take it in stride. He's a really nice guy.
No blood, no foul. All right. It's like the NBA here, too. So
there's the U.S. team coach, Pat Henderson, taking it in stride as well.
Max Dempsey takes a seat. Rough go here in the finals and back on the women's double mini finals. And this is Australian Sally-Ann Propach, the 1992 women's champ in the Australian Open.
She's got a good run going. Solid pull. But that, I think, is an error because she just did a simple Barani straight off. And at this level, I know these girls are playing through at least one double somersault. And I think she was a little far on the end of the bed and just tried to save the routine. There's the spotter skill. That means it's on the same bed that she takes off from. And there's the Barani off.
Maybe her steps were not quite right coming down the runway.
Yeah, that can have a lot to do with it. Usually they don't have too much trouble with their run, but if their steps get off a little bit, it can really cause problems in the routine.
And now back to the trampoline and from Osaka, Japan, Kateoke Seiichi.
Seiichi finished along with the rest of his Japanese teammates as the seventh best team in the world in Auckland. He's doing a really good routine right now. What he did is called a flip this ball out. It's 2.25 rotations off your back with a half twist. But throughout the rest of the routine, there wasn't a high level of difficulty shown.
Seiichi out of Saka University, a sports science major in college.
There is the flip this ball out. Clean, but not a high degree of difficulty.
There's hang time. We'll take a brief break. We'll be back with more and complete our coverage here in the men's trampoline and the women's double mini tramp finals, the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego. Stay with us on Prime Network.
Go up with somebody. Thanks.
Welcome back to the Indo-Pacific Games from 1993 here on Prime Network and Home Sports Entertainment. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you as we will complete the competition in the women's double mini finals and the men's trampoline. Next up, Davina Radcliffe from Canada.
Davina was second at the 1992 Canadian National Championships. See how she does here. So Rudy over to a double twisting back saltoir. Very good form. A little conservative, but when you do it that well, it sometimes pays off. There's the Rudolph. That's a 1.5 twisting forward somersault. And the double twisting backward somersault. Now, if you notice, she twisted with her arms down by her sides. A lot of your best athletes now have developed that style of twisting with their arms right by their sides rather than in by their chest.
Davina from British Columbia, the Junior Gymnast of the Year in Canada in 1989. And now, back on the men's tramp, is Carl Hager.
Carl was third in the last Indo-Pacific Games in Australia in 1991, so I know he's hoping to at least finish there.
Carl out of Manhattan, Kansas.
Return for Carl. Really happy for him.
Hager finished eighth earlier here today in the double mini tramp finals. And we mentioned that he had won a medal, a real medal we're talking about, folks, over Desert Storm as an exceptional performance by a platoon leader. And who knows, maybe he'll get one here.
You can see Carl performs a very high degree of difficulty and he did it very well.
He was ranked seventh in the preliminaries. Do you think he's got a shot to move up?
Oh, yeah, I think definitely.
Carl Hager, and now to the women's mini double, or double mini finals, I should say, and back to Jamie Strandmark out of Excelsior, Minnesota for the USA team.
Jamie's really a talented little girl. She has terrific body lines and a terrific finish. That was a granny in full out. As her dismount skill.
Just 14, Jamie Strandmark.
You can see it here. Starts with a back somersault in the straight position, and then a branny in full twist on the second flip. Just one step.
You mentioned her athleticism. She's part of the ski club, plays a little soccer, so more than just the gymnastics field and the double mini finals here. And on the men's tramp, this is Jai Wallace again from Australia.
Wallace had planned to do an 11.1.
What is the range of difficulty that they have made plans to do here from?
Well, the range is pretty much from a 6.5 to a 13.0. So Jai is relatively on the high end. He's already showing you how easy it is to get caught traveling from one side of the bed. Now he's pulled it back into the center now. But there again, those are all deductions every time he leaves the center.
Sometimes difficult to see by the camera angle to see that red cross there right in the middle, and that is the point that the judges are looking so closely for, to stay in the center.
Right. Trampoline judging is not that easy. You have to watch for a lot of things. For instance, here, he's got pretty good body line, but there you saw him cowboy, where his knees came apart. We call that cowboying. That's a deduction. He did that to increase rotation. And then you see him bend his knees a little bit there before he initiates the twist on the Rudy out. Those are all deductions besides the traveling on the mat, so they have a lot to watch.
15-year-old Jai Wallace. Jackie Cully now, another Australian, 18-year-old.
Cully was second at the 1991 Indos. But unfortunately, she's having a really off day here. She missed her first routine, and this routine had problems as well.
Should mention, am I right, the Indo-Pacific Games alternate in the odd-numbered years, and then the World Championships are in the even-numbered years.
Exactly. Exactly. Here you can see the spotter double back, and she just stopped.
How do these countries compare, Tim, with the other countries that we see in the World Championships?
Well, as far as the sport of tumbling goes, the Americans are the leaders, I believe, in the sport of tumbling. It's almost like an inner squad meet sometimes. We're so far advanced, like the former Soviet Union in gymnastics. But in trampolining, the European countries are very strong. Countries like Canada and Australia have made tremendous strides. Canada is just incredible. The guy you see bouncing now, J.P. Aquan, has improved immensely since the last time I saw him and has a legitimate shot to win here.
J.P. Aquan from Canada is to mention the ninth of 10 competitors.
There's a Triffus pike, half and half out pike, Rudy out pike, half and Rudy out tuck, Branny and full out tuck, full and full out tuck, half out pike, half and half out tuck, and Branny and full out, and full and full out. It's a lot of stuff going on in that routine. He did it real well. He's got to be happy with himself. Looks like he's limping a little bit. Something happened.
62.9 in the prelims, finishing just behind Chris Mitrick at 63.2. Mitrick will be the last one in just a minute. Maybe we can see something here on the replay.
Looks like he cut his toe. There's a little blood on his shoe there. You can see here. He was on this on the end of the bed and
from Toronto, J.P. Aquan, and
12.4 degree of difficulty in that routine. Very high level.
Hopefully he's okay. Now Alana Bolton, 18-year-old from Auckland, New Zealand, the final competitor here in the women's double mini trampoline.
And Bolton is wonderful in this event. She finished fourth at the 1992 World Championships. So if she hits here, she might have a shot. That's really what good double mini is all about. Two double somersaults in the routine with good form and a nice landing. She had a little hop. For the most part, it was a pretty good routine.
Well, she's done some judging of her own, so she should know. Competing in the 1992 World Championships. And that completes the women's double mini finals. We'll have the scoring for you in just a little bit. One more to go on the trampoline, though, on the men's side. And Chris Mitrick, he put on quite a show in the preliminaries today.
Yeah, Chris is just an amazing athlete. He recently set set the second highest difficulty record ever recorded, which was a 14.4. I don't know if he's planning on doing it here today. He has listed only a 13.0, but even that is really amazing. See how high he is. But trouble, big trouble there. Too bad for Chris.
Well, he struggled in the double mini, and then now he has problems here after doing so well in the preliminaries. Tough day.
And it's so unfortunate because in training and in the preliminary, he was just astounding, and everyone's been talking about him. And then he at this Triffus pike seems to be going well. He leans a little backwards. Does that half in Rudy out pike, and it's all over.
Tough way to finish the day for Chris Mitrick, 19-year-old from Burlington, Ontario, Canada. We take a brief break. We'll be back with more. Stick around. The real fun starts in just a minute. We get to the men's power tumbling and the women's synchronized trampoline. More coming up on the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games from San Diego. You're watching Prime Network. Welcome back to the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego, California on Prime Network. We've got a look at the results of the double mini tramp for the women's competition. And Elena Bolton of New Zealand finishing first with 9.60, followed by the USA in second and third with Jamie Strandmark and Karen Vandermeer. And then Davina Radcliffe from Canada and the United States' Melissa Larson finishing in the fifth position. Following that, we'll take a look at 6 through 10, Proposh, as well as Stevens, Shaw, Vanderwalt, and Cully. Now on the men's side in the trampoline finals, Paul Cameron of Canada starts a 1-2 finish for the Canadians. J.P. Aquan finishing second, and Carl Hager in third with a little bit of a surprise.
Yeah, it was a great thing for Carl Hager. I've known him a long time. He's a good man, and it's nice to see him finish there.
And that's a look at the trampoline finals from the men's side. Now we're all set here for maybe the most exciting event that we'll have here in the Indo-Pacific Games, and that's the men's power tumbling finals. We've also got the synchronized tramp for the women coming up, and I know you're excited about this, Tim Schlosser.
Yeah, this one really gets my blood boiling. I was a tumbler way back when on the U.S. team, and the level of difficulty and the skills these guys are doing is just amazing right now.
And we start off with a Canadian, Jimmy Lamar, just 16 out of British Columbia.
Okay, it was a good routine. It was clean, but it just doesn't have the big multiple twisting, multiple somersaults that you'll see performed later by the American men. There you see a full twisting front step out, round off, whip back, full twist, whip back, whip back, to a back tuck, punch front. That's a relatively easy routine at this level of competition.
Jimmy Lamar, and if you look closely, we'll see his twin brother coming up in just a few, as Jimmy finished 10th in the prelims, so he starts things off in the finals. Now to the women's synchronized trampoline, and the USA team goes first with Jennifer Sands and Christy Hayes.
And Hayes is the American synchro champion with a different partner, veteran Lee Hennessy. But these two teamed up for the Indo-Pacific competition.
How much time do they actually get to work out together?
Actually, it depends. If they're from the same club, they get a lot of time to work out together. But if not, we saw something very interesting right there that usually doesn't happen. They both bent their legs at exactly the same time on their last skill.
Did they realize it?
I don't know. I don't know.
Almost looks like they did in the reaction from, particularly from Hayes.
Here's Branny Strait. Double twist. They're in perfect synchronization. There's back somersault pikes. They're just wonderful together. Here's 1 3/4 front flips. And then right here, they both did similar finishes, similar form breaks, synchronized form breaks.
If one breaks, the other goes with it. That is synchronization.
American coach Pat Henderson picked that up, obviously.
And now back to the power tumbling finals, and Donald Rice from Amarillo, Texas.
Beautiful double layout through to a full in, back out in the pike position. That's two big, difficult somersaults in one exercise.
Well, this is the Americans' top event, and Rice shows you why.
It's beautiful form. Here's the double layout somersault. He moves through well with a whip back, back handspring, little high there, and a full in pike back somersault. But if he didn't really press in for the landing and caught the floor and had a big deduction on the landing, still get good scores. He's very clean.
Donald Rice out of West Texas A&M, as it's called now, a business major. And now to the Japan pair here of Tomaka Hitomi and Noguchi Tomo.
Got themselves back together, but they're having some form problems throughout the exercise. The same finish 1 3 pike, but a brandy by that time. It's a good routine, but it shouldn't put them in front of the Americans.
Hitomi and Tomo from Japan, the second of six pairs that will compete in the synchronized.
Here they are. You can see they're doing relatively easy skills, single somersaults. Here's a 1 3/4 front for their finish and a brandy ball out tuck. Synchronization was good, though.
They wait for their scores, and we'll move next to another American in the power tumbling, Brad Davis out of Pittsburgh, Kansas.
And Brad is one of the most naturally talented athletes I've ever seen in my life. Back and full out straight to a full, to a flip-flop, full and full out tuck. What a shame. What a shame.
Well, Brad at Pittsburgh State University in Kansas, he's a physical therapy major. The nickname of that school is the Gorillas, and he takes a gorilla approach to his event, doesn't he?
Well, Brad's kind of a kamikaze when it comes to tumbling. He just lets it all go, and he's really moving through this routine. And he just ended up having a little more juice than he thought he would. Right there, tries to see the floor, but he landed on his heels with his hips too far back, and there's just nothing you can do. It's unfortunate he had a real shot. He's the defending Pan Pacific champion.
Brad Davis, 22 years old. Now again, another Japan pair, Mayuki and Megumi. Tada Mayuki and Sasuke Megumi from Japan on the synchronized.
As you watch them move through the routine, they're having some form breaks, and when one athlete goes off the tramp like that, there's just nothing left to be done. It's a tough event.
A rough go for Mayuki and Megumi, and take one more look at it. It can be so much fun to watch when they are in perfect synchronization, and when one gets off, it can get a bit ugly.
Yeah.
And disappointment for the Japanese pair. We'll take a timeout. More coming up from the 93 Indo-Pacific Games here in San Diego. Stay with us. Back in San Diego at the concourse here in California, Indo-Pacific Games 1993. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you. Glad to have you with us, and you're thinking, wait a minute, we just saw Jimmy Lamar. No, this is twin brother Robbie Lamar, ready to go. The fourth competitor out of 10 in the men's power tumbling finals.
Robbie's doing well, he's moving well down the mat. Pretty stock routine. He tumbles just like his brother as well. They do very similar type of skills, whip combinations with full twist, but not big double somersaults. He does a branny to a full twist to a whip back. Looks a little bit off axis there. Full twist to another full twist, bounding full twist, and a punch front somersault.
Power tumbling seems to be the sport, though, that certainly the older athletes are going to do better. It's not the younger because of the strength involved.
Right, right. The stronger you get, the more experience you get, the better you're going to become.
Brother Jimmy looking on as Robbie finishes up. And now we'll move back to the synchronized trampoline, and from Canada, Davina Radcliffe and Coralia Puchmeyer. Puchmeyer claimed a medal, finishing third in the women's tramp earlier.
One.
So far, so
two.
Good for the Canadian pair. Start with half-out pikes, full twists, half-out tucks. You can see they're off now. And you saw one of the Canadian girls cut the routine to try to get back, but I think she's cut a little bit too much. Pretty good content in the routine, but problems with the synchronization.
Tough time recovering for Radcliffe and Puchmeyer from Canada. Six teams competing in the synchronized trampoline, and let's see what went wrong here.
Okay, you can see they're off already. And right here, right there, you see the Canadian nearest to us try to cut the routine. She does a pretty good job, but then she's too low. She's hitting the bed first now.
How aware are you of what your partner's doing? And how do you know if one makes the adjustment, the other won't counter and also
yeah,
try to make adjustments?
That's what makes the event so tough. But usually, because of all the intense training they do, they are able to really get a sense of where the other person is.
Steve Granary now, Canadian from Edmonton, Alberta.
Wow. And I did not see him hit that one time in warm-ups, and he just came through in a big way for the Canadian team.
It's been that kind of day here, hasn't it? Some
yeah.
People have performed very well in the preliminaries, and the warm-ups have not done so when it's counted. He does just the opposite.
Yeah. And he's doing a twisting combination pass with some whip somersaults and then two back handsprings. to a double twisting, double back. It's not all that high, but he just grits his teeth and pulls it around. You can tell Steve, he's got to be happy.
Yeah.
He's breathing a sigh of relief.
And now to the USA pair of Karen Helm and Melissa Larson, synchronized trampoline.
These are wonderful American trampolinists. They have a real good shot if they hit this routine to stay in medal contention. Oh, that's too bad. Melissa stops in the middle of the routine. She's been having problems with a back injury.
So Larson stops, and of course Helm continued on to finish. But it has been a rough go in much of the women's synchronized tramp here.
There's their half and half out pike somersaults, half out tuck somersaults, half and half out tuck somersaults. And there, Melissa was a little crooked on the end, and probably to stay on the tramp, she stopped the routine. Coach Pat Henderson is their personal coach as well, and she knows the girls very well.
Now Dion Forster from South Africa, just turned 17.
Dion begins with some twist combinations to a full and back out tuck. Opened up a little soon, didn't have a lot of height, and didn't pull his knees in quite hard enough.
All these contestants were asked for their hobbies, and Dion let us know that, like, rugby, cricket, music, and parties. One of your favorite hobbies, isn't it, Tim?
Well, you can see Dion here shortens up the back handsprings a little bit, still tries to pull around the full end, but then opens up a little soon and reaches for the mat.
Just couldn't quite make it. Dion Forster. They can all smile because these are the best, the very best that are here in the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games. And to wrap up the competition on the synchronized trampoline, Jackie Cully and Donna White from Australia, they were number one in the preliminaries. Look at synchronized swimming in the Olympics. Will we have synchronized trampoline someday?
Well, I sure hope so. It's very exciting to watch these kids perform, doing a high level of difficulty. And when they do it well, like this team is right here, it's just beautiful. And that was terrific. Good form, good difficulty, and excellent synchronization, and they are very happy.
Cully and White look at one another and realize that they might very well have held that number one spot.
Here they are doing back somersaults in the pike position, Rudy's, double twisting back somersaults. That's 1 3/4 front pikes to Rudy ball outs perfectly together. Even perfect toe point on the stretch bounce at the end.
We'll take a break. When we come back in the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games, we'll wrap up the men's power tumbling, the best still to come. Stay with us on Prime Network from here in San Diego. Four competitors remain in the power tumbling finals here of the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games. And next up is Aaron Richards from Australia, 17-year-old. Teaching some beginners in tumbling. So, like you, Tim Schlosser, everyone likes to move on to the coaching area, I guess.
Pass is moving well. Nice for Tim. Did a long pass, traveled down the whole mat, finished with a high full in, back out in the tuck position. The problem Aaron's going to face is the competition from the American, Don Rice, who has a lot more degree of difficulty. But he does a good job right there, only one step on the landing.
Gets his score. And next up, you look at the judges and might explain a little bit the scoring.
Well, all the passes are scored performance-wise out of 10.0, and then the difficulty is added on to that. So those scores, 9.2, 9.3, very good.
Here is Seiko Mogatse out of South Africa.
Seiko starts with the granny to a double cutback somersault, works through to a full in, full out. I think he hit the line. I think he stepped on the line. We'll have to see what the line judge says.
He had his own fan club up here that did their own cheer before he started.
We'll see if we can spot that here. There's a branny to a whip back, back handspring, tuck double back somersault, whip back handspring, and a full in, full out. But I think he stepped over the line at the end.
His second year of elite level competition, Seiko Mogatse, and next up will be Rayshine Harris from the United States, 19-year-old. The scores come out.
And those reflect the fact that he did step on that line. That's at least a 9/10 deduction at the end.
And now here's Harris out of Newark, New Jersey.
Right, Rayshine comes from the Flip City tumbling program that has continually produced some of the best tumblers this country has ever seen. It's a full and full out to the whip back, two back handsprings, and back in double full out. Now what's amazing about that routine is that Rayshine did not do that routine one time in the warm-up event. He totally adjusted. He came off the full in, full out a little bit short. And he totally adjusted. That superb coaching. There's the full, full, and you can see right there, he gets a little stuck, doesn't move through that well, but then moves very strong and throws back in, double full out.
Is he trying to make it to the other landing area?
Yeah, he was. You know, it's a lot easier to land on that softer surface than it is on the bouncy ski floor. But as you can see right there, the score is still very good because he knew what to do, he knew how to get himself back into the position he needed to be.
Out of Seton Hall, where he's a computer science major. And next up will be John Beck, and here's your world champ, folks. 24-year-old, does a little coaching himself out of Metairie, Louisiana.
Right, and John is really the class of this field. He's quickly becoming a legend in the sport. He just about wins everything anymore. And that is the way tumbling should be. That is just amazing.
Oh, mama.
He did a back and pull out straight through to a double twisting double back with beautiful form, speed, and rhythm.
And now you know why John Beck is the world champ.
There's round of whip back, then he does a back handspring. Now watch this, back somersault in, full out, perfect form. Moves right through with the whip back to back handspring, full in, full out. Look at his knees are pasted together, toes pointed, and one tiny little step. And big scores for John Beck as well. 9-6, 9-5, 9-5. Really good job.
So John Beck wraps things up in the men's power tumbling finals and gets a hug from Rayshine Harris. They both had outstanding routines. We'll take a brief break. We'll come back and have a chance to visit about what we've seen here this afternoon. Hope you've enjoyed all the action. Stay with us. We'll talk more about the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games when we return on Prime Network. Welcome back to the wrap-up of the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego here on Prime Network. Bill Land and Tim Schlosser with you. We've got some surprises. Don't you dare tune out yet. We'll take a look at the results here for the women's synchronized trampoline. And no surprise here as Donna White and Jackie Cully combined with a 43.60 to get the gold from Australia. In second, United States' Jennifer Sands and Christy Hayes at 41.4. And then the Japan pair of Tomo and Hitomi, followed by Radcliffe and Puchmeyer from Canada, Japan's Mayuki and Megumi, and then from the United States, Helm and Larson in the sixth position. Now for the surprise. In the men's power tumbling final, Rayshine Harris has upset the world champion John Beck. Harris with a 27.4667, if you take it all the way out. And Beck, his USA teammate and the defending world champ, 27.4. Brad Davis gives the U.S. a 1-2-3 sweep at 26.16. And the U.S. with Donald Rice in the fourth position. So once again, the United States showing its domination in the power tumbling. Steve Granary in fifth, and then on down, Aaron Richards of Australia, Mogotsi of South Africa, Robbie Lamar and Jimmy Lamar, the twins from Canada, and Dion Vorster from South Africa in the number 10 slot. And my partner, Tim Schlosser, is with an outstanding performer here today, Rayshine Harris from the United States, who knocks off John Beck. Let's throw it down to Tim.
Thanks, Bill. Rayshine, what a competition. Gosh, we watched the senior championships, and you did a terrific job in that competition. It was really close. John finished on top there. You came back and upset him here. What do you think?
Well, I think I did a good job, and John deserves a lot of credit because he worked really hard. And so.
Okay, what we're going to do, Rayshine, is we're going to look on the monitor there at John's pass. Tell us what you think of this. See, he's doing his whip saltos there.
Mm-hmm.
Does a back and full out, whip, and then a full in, full out.
When he goes into the flip, he bends his arms a whole lot.
And so that's where you think they hit him, huh?
Yeah, and on that step at the end.
Okay, now this is yours coming up right here. There you go. There's a full in, full out, and your whip. Now, I thought you had changed routine because I had seen you putting a full and full out straight on the end there, and then you just totally did this back and double full out. Surprised me. I had no idea you could even do that.
Yeah.
So what do you think? Pretty happy with that one?
Yes, very happy.
Here it comes once more. I think it was very close as far as performance-wise, but the difficulty, I think you had a little bit higher difficulty, and that's what ended up winning it for you.
Mm-hmm.
So, pretty happy with the way things turned out then?
Yes.
Tell us a little bit, if you can, what's in store for you in the future. I know your coach, Dave Green, very well. I know how you guys train in Flip City. What do you guys have prepared for us in the future? What competitions or training, stuff like that?
Well, I really couldn't tell you that, but if you ask my coach, he will tell you.
Kind of the secret thing going on. You guys are going to surprise us, probably have more better stuff for us next year?
Maybe.
Okay, great. Okay, well, thanks a lot, Rayshine. Congratulations. You did a terrific job.
Thank you, Tim.
Back to you, Bill.
Thank you, Tim, and congratulations to Rayshine Harris out of Newark, New Jersey, as he certainly shocked John Beck and the field here in winning the championship in the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games Power Tumbling event. We'll be back with more. Stay with us on Prime Network as we'll come back and wrap things up from San Diego, California at the concourse, the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games on Prime. Welcome back to San Diego in the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games at the concourse in San Diego. Hi, everyone. I'm Bill Land along with Tim Schlosser, and what a finish we saw here. No one would have predicted the controversy, the appeals, the protests that we saw in the last segment. You had an opportunity to hear from Rayshine Harris, the champion in the men's power tumbling. John Beck, the world champion, who was defeated. He filed a protest. It was denied. And he just so disappointed. He didn't care to come on the air with us, Tim, and I understand his disappointment. Obviously, we both at least leaned that Beck would win this thing. Let's go back and let's take a look at Beck's pass again and tell us your thoughts again now that we know the outcome.
Okay, well, John really did a terrific job here. He starts, you can see there, with his round off, his whip over.
Where did he lose some
points? Over. Well, so far, nowhere. The back handspring's good. Here's his back in, full out, and that is just beautiful. His legs are pasted together, good form, good rhythm off the back and full out, to whip back, back handspring, and a full in, full out tuck. And you look, his knees are tight, his toes are pointed, and he just nails it. So I think the performance level was incredible on that routine. Now let's watch Rayshine here.
And this actually occurred with Harris going first, then Beck, but we thought you might want to see Beck's performance first and then Harris.
And here's Rayshine. He's doing a double twisting, double back at the beginning, then two whip backs, two back handspring, back handspring, and then here's the controversy. Back in, double full out, and they called that position a straight body position or the layout position. That really increases the difficulty. It really increases the difficulty, and therefore, Rayshine Harris beat John Beck simply because of a knee, you know, no knee bend, where we thought maybe he had bent his knees a little bit too much and called it a tuck. The judges called it a straight body position, and he became the champion.
What about the landing? Is that a point that Beck thought might bring it in his favor because of Harris landing?
No, I think the landings were fairly similar. I mean, Beck seemed a little more solid on the landing, but it was all in the difficulty of that very last skill. If the judges would have ruled that skill a tuck, then John Beck would have been the champion. But since they ruled it a straight body position, the difficulties shot way up, and we now have a new Indo-Pacific champion.
Well, thanks to Replay. Do you agree with the decision before we go on?
It's a really close call. I mean, you hate to say, because you bend your body. Sometimes they call it a tuck. Sometimes they call it a straight. I think we need to be more specific as how much it should be tucked and how much, you know, in order to call those positions.
Well, I hope you've had a chance to learn a little bit about the sport. We certainly have here today something new. It doesn't matter what event it is. And we're going to go back. If you might recall, at the beginning of the program, we talked about the events that we'd bring you today. You've just seen the men's power tumbling. Let's go back and take a look at some of the tape. We'll go back with the girls and the women's double mini tramp.
This, of course, is the double mini tramp event, and you can see this is Karen Vandermeer. She's doing her wonderful Rudy over double pike that she just nailed. Shows the power and speed of that event.
A lot of neat stories here today. One of them is Carl Hager and his outstanding performance in the men's trampoline.
Yeah, I was really excited for Carl. He did a beautiful optional routine, a lot of difficulty, a lot of style, and hit it right on the cross. And he's been around a long time, and he really deserves to medal again here at the Indo-Pacifics.
Ended up with a third. And that, of course, the one event that most people are probably most familiar with. You saw some outstanding performers today. And then the synchronized trampolining, and these turned out to be the champions from Australia, White and Cully.
Yeah, Australians were just wonderful. I mean, this routine was right on. Every single trick they did, they were in the bed at the same time, and the body shapes in the air were just wonderful.
And they come out with the gold.
Really shows here the beauty of synchronized trampolining, like they're flying through the air. Flying through the air and doing a lot while they're doing it.
Let's talk about power tumbling and trampolining overall, Tim. It's an affiliated sport with the Olympics, so it's made the first step. What's next, and what are the chances that we'll have a chance to see these great events performed in the Olympics someday?
Well, I really hope that power tumbling, trampoline, double mini tramp, and synchronized trampoline have a shot to be in the Olympic Games, because it is just one of the most exciting things to see happen when you see these kids fly down the mat or jump 30 feet in the air, flipping all over the place. We've got our world championships coming up next year in Portugal, and who knows, we might see a new world champion, or maybe John Beck will come back and regain that title, you know.
Certainly adds some flair to it, doesn't it?
Yeah. Sets up a very interesting competition for next year.
When you take a look at the sport overall and the hours and the time and the competition that goes in, we certainly want to appreciate not all of the performers, not just them and what they've done, but all the people who have helped put this thing together here with the ATTA.
Yeah, ATTA did a great job. We had a wonderful support group from the California coaching community, and the officers and the board of directors for the ATTA worked very, very hard to really make this competition run smoothly.
Olympics or not, you still see great growth for this sport?
Yeah, I absolutely do. I think we have shots at things like the Pan American Games or the National Sports Festival, and we have the World Games coming up in The Hague in the Netherlands next month. So I think the sport's really going to go places in the future.
Tim, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much. Appreciate
your help. Thank you, Bill.
For Tim Schlosser, this is Bill Land saying so long from San Diego. Hope you've enjoyed all the competition, all the fun, and the great events here of the 1993 Indo-Pacific Games in San Diego. So long, everybody.